One good thing when coding WordPress themes is not to duplicate parts and reuse existing ones when it's possible. Because for the next templates, I will need to have the same elements in my documents, this is the right time to create reusable template parts. From my index page, I'm going to create reusable templates from my header and from my main menu. Let's start with the header. I add the reusable template part Smart Action. I set the path and name. And that's it. Next is my main menu. I do the same, so I enter the path and name. I save and export my theme. Now, I'm ready to deal with the About page. First, the page settings. I set the export name for my document by following the WordPress guidelines about templates naming. I add a post template name, and I set the template to be available as a template for pages only. For the header, I set the reusable template part action, and I select the main header that I have created earlier in this video. For the navbar, I do the same things, and I select the main navbar template. Time to add my main loop. I set the post title action on the H1. And the post content on the first paragraph. As usual, I set the don't export to the unneeded content. Now, for the team section, I add the show post smart action, but this time I'm going to use a custom query and a custom post type. I add the post type name. I set the query name. I set the number of posts per page. Then I select Register the custom post type. I see two new fields for the post type, the plural name and the singular name. I fill both values. I set the post featured image action to the first image. I set the image size to the one I have created during the theme setup. I add the post title smart action to the team member name, and my query is ready. Again, I set the Don't Export action to the unneeded elements. And finally, I add a name to the section. From my local WordPress, I see that the team member's custom post type is available, so I create the three team members. The name of the team member as the title, and the team member picture as the featured image. Now, I select the About page, and from the Page Attributions panel, I set my new template. I save the page, and I check the result. From what I see, my query is not correct as I don't loop the right element, so let's fix it. From Pinegrow, I select my loop, and from the repeated loop item, I can exactly select which element to loop because it's highlighted in the tree. Again, I save, then export. I refresh the page, and now the result is all right. Let's now deal with the social network links. For this, I use the Advanced Custom Fields plugin. I create a new field group, which I name Social Networks. I set the group to be available only for team members' custom post type. I add a first field for the Twitter link. I set the field label. The field name. I set the field type to link. And I enter the instructions. I do the same for the Facebook field. Because Google Plus does not exist anymore, I pass on this one. I save my field group by clicking the Publish button. Back to my team members' pages, the social network fields are now available, so I add the corresponding links to all my members. From Pinegrow, I select the first link and I start to add the first post field. As usual, I use the Update Field List. But because I forgot to enter the preview URL, Pinegrow is not able to find the available fields. Back to my local WordPress, I copy the page URL, then from the page settings, I paste the value. I save and reload my page. Now, I can add the post field action to my link. And I'm now able to update the fields list. I set up my Twitter field. The next link being the Google Plus one, I set it to Don't Export. I proceed the same for the Facebook link. I save my document and export the theme. From my local WordPress, I can now see the links.